guys, George Makes Pizza and I'm back. I've got a new video for you. In this video, I'm gonna be doing something a little bit different. So I did my GCSEs back in 2013. Yes, I'm very old. But I've seen loads of you guys posting on social media that you're doing your GCSEs now and been messaging me like for advice and stuff like that. However, GCSEs have changed quite a lot since I did them. Like before when I did them spread out over the year. So I do one at like the beginning, one in the middle, and one at the end. Whereas now I think you guys do them all at the end. So we're gonna be doing the 2017 higher paper. So I'm excited to see how I do. But just so we start, guys, this week's squad shout out goes to Keely Cotty. Thank you so much, Keely, for being in the squad. I always see you coming to my videos. Thank you so much. We're gonna do a second squad shout out as well this week because I forgot to do one last week. So the second one goes to MarkW9907 on Twitter. Thank you so much, Mark, for being so active on Twitter, and thank you for being in the squad. If you would like to be next week's squad chat and get a shout out in next week's video, all you have to do is follow me on Instagram and Twitter, and make sure you comment down below saying you're in the squad and what social media platforms you follow me on. But yeah, guys, without further ado, let's get straight on with the maths. GCSE. Okay, so we are here, we are ready to do this GCSE exam. We've got this camera here and we've also got this camera here, which is kind of like an over-the-shoulder camera so you can see exactly what I'm looking at on my exam paper. And I guess you guys can kind of play along at home and see if you can get the questions right, because I'm not gonna lie, I'm not that confident. I did get a C at GCSE a few years ago. I'm not gonna lie, since then I haven't done much maths and I definitely haven't revised. So don't judge me. I'm also boiling hot. It's literally like, I don't know how hot it is. It's like 20 degrees. It's 26 degrees! What the hell? It's 26 degrees! I thought it was like 20 degrees. I was like, it's hot, but it's 26. And I'm sitting inside doing a GCSE exam. We've actually got an invigilator coming, so make sure there's no cheating. It's all exam conditions, so he should be here quite soon.
Hello, Klopp. Oh, where is everyone?
Oh, did they not tell you? It's just me today.
Just you?
Yeah, just me.
This is exactly what's wrong with the youth today, I'll tell you that.
Yeah.
Anyway, I've got your paper here.
Sorry, man. Sorry.
Reflexes of a goldfish.
Anyway, you any good at maths? I mean, I'm not terrible. I know about the basic maths, like 2 + 2 = 4, -1, that's 3. Quick maths. Okay.
I don't get paid enough for this job, I'll tell you that. You've got 1 hour 30 minutes. Get on with it.
Okay, so a timer for 1 hour 30 minutes. Starting now. Let's go. GCSE. Paper 1. Non-calculator. Let's go. The scatter graph shows the maximum temperature and the number of hours of sunshine in 14 British towns in one day. So, what am I supposed to do now? One of the points is an outlier. What's an outlier? I'm guessing it's that one. I'm guessing it's something that doesn't follow the trend. 10, 10, 19. There you go, that's got to be one mark already. For all the points, write down the type of correlation. The type of correlation. I mean, what types of correlation are there? Oh, is it positive? Yeah, it's positive, positive. It's going up, right? 2 solid marks on the book. I should stop ripping this. I messed up the paperclip. Question 3. On the same day in another British town, the maximum temperature was 16 degrees Celsius. Estimate the number of hours of sunshine in this town on this day. What? How am I supposed to do that? Right, so this is how it worked. It was 16.4. 16.4. 2, 4, 6, 8. 16.4. That's there. Bang, right there. Put it right there. Oh, this pen. Yay! Okay, that equals. You know what? I think it's 13. You think it's 13? It's only an estimate. Let's just say 13. Actually, let's not say 13. Let's say, can I say half? 12 hours and 45 minutes. Okay, so the next question is, a weatherman says, temperatures are higher when there is more sunshine. Does the scatter graph support what the weatherman says? Well, I mean, he's the weatherman, so I'm guessing he knows what he's talking about. So if you look here, there's not a lot of sunshine and it's lower. And then here, yeah, he's right. He's a weatherman. Obviously, he's right. Yes. Give a reason for your answer. Because he's a weatherman. And probably has a degree in that sort of thing. Wait, why did I have to even give a reason for my answer? It's only one mark. Give a reason for your answer. What reason is there? Yes, because he's right. And it follows the correlation. Boom. Right. Dab on them haters. Number 2. Express 56 as a product of its prime factors. What are prime factors again? Is a prime factor the one where you times it by itself and then it's that? What's 56 divided by 56? That's 1. Yeah, I know what it is. So 2 is a prime factor because 56 is in the 2 times table. No, what is a prime factor? I don't think that is a prime factor. I've said prime factor so much it doesn't even sound like a real word anymore. Is a prime factor? 1's a prime factor. I don't think 1 counts, but 1, 2, 4 is. Do I have to just list all the numbers that go into 56? I'm just gonna put 8. That'll do. Number 8. Okay, next question. Work out 54.6
times 4.3.
Oh, this is hard.
You know what? We're going to skip this question. Don't know how to do that. Next question. The area of square ABCD is 10 centimeters squared. Show that x squared plus 6x equals 1.
Bruh. What did you just ask me to do?
I'm getting hungry, I'm just gonna get some food.
Got some food.
Sweet and salted popcorn. Also, I know some of you are doing your GCSEs and you've probably done this paper as a mock exam. Comment down below if this paper was actually harder or easier than the one you've done this year. Because I tried to get the 2018 one, but they don't release it till like 6 months. So I had to do the 2017 one. But yeah, tell me how this year's paper went. Equation of line L is y equals 3x minus 1. Show that these two lines are parallel. How do you want me to do that? I'm pretty sure the syllabus has changed since I left school, so that's my experience. You know what? We're skipping this question. That literally just blew my brain. Okay, so next question. There are 10 boys and 20 girls in a class. Class had a test. The mean mark for all the class is 60. The mean mark for the girls is 54. Work out what the mean mark for the boys is. So the average for girls was 54, and the average for boys was 64. No, it wasn't. It wasn't 64. So it was 66. It was 66, right? Oh no, but there's twice the amount of girls. Don't try and trip me up at Excel. They're trying to trip me up. I've got this. The girls got 54, but there's twice the amount of them. I think it's 63. There's 6 less for the girls, so half it, that's 3. Okay, next question. Write 7.97 times 10 minus 6. As an ordinary number.
What an ordinary number?
Honestly, I have no idea what an ordinary number is. I don't know how to work this out. Let's just put 12. Jules buys a washing machine. 20% VAT is added to the price of the washing machine. Jules then has to pay a total of £600. What is the price of the washing machine with no VAT added? This is one of the maths questions that you actually need in real life. I mean, the others, I don't know when you're ever gonna have to make a number an ordinary number or work out the value of X and Y times 26. So what's 20% of 500. 100. So, oh, it's 500. It's £500. Show that x plus 1. Why is there so many x's in this paper? X plus 1, x plus 2, x plus 3 can be written in the form of ax3. What?
No, I can't be doing that.
So we're going on to the next question. Okay, next question. N is an integer greater than 1. What's an integer? Prove algebraically. I didn't even know that was a word. It's like alphabetically, but algebraically. You know what? That's a good question. How do I prove that algebraically? Find out the value of 81 to the power of minus half. Not doing that one. Find the value of 6. No, we're not doing that one either. The graph of y equals... Why is everything y, x, y, z, b, w, 12, 11. Write down the coordinates of the turning point in the graph. So the turning point's right here, right? Pretty sure it's 1, am I right? Tell me I'm right. Use the graph to find an estimate for f1.5 as f. What is f? There's a y-axis and x-axis. Where does the f come from? Okay, next question. A, B, C, D is a rhombus. Who doesn't love a rhombus? Find the equation of diagonal AC.
Nope.
O, A, B, C is a parallelogram. Parallelograms are my favourite. OA equals A and OC equals C. X is the midpoint of the line AC. OCD is a straight line so that OC and CD equals K1. Given that XD is 3... This is literally just throwing numbers and alphabet letters at my face. ABCD is a quadrilateral.
Quadrilateral.
AB equals CD. Angle ABC, angle BCD. Prove that AC equals BD. So this is AC right there, and that's BD. AC, DC. AB, CD. A. Thing is, I don't remember this being on my like exam. Maybe it was, but how can you prove something? I mean, if you look at it as a diagram, it's pretty much even, you know, a reflection of itself. Maybe that's the deeper meaning of this exam. That shapes are not just shapes. They're more than shapes. They're almost like butterflies in the reflection of themselves. On one side you have AB and the other side you have CD. But what you don't realize is CD is just a reflection of AB. And what people need to realize is shapes need to love themselves just like AB loves themselves, because CD is AB. That's my answer. I don't know how to put that in words or numbers or equations. Last question. The diagram shows a hexagon ABCDEF. What? Do I even attempt this? ABEF, CBED are congruent parallelograms. Congruent parallelogram. Where AB equals BC equals X centimeters. P is the point on AF and Q is the point on CD. Such that BP equals BQ equals 10 centimeters. Given that angle ABC equals 30 degrees, prove that cos PBQ equals 1 minus, I don't even know how to say that. Is this even maths? What is this? You know what? I'm done. I can't answer anymore. Okay guys, so we're now back. It's been like an hour. I've had time to release my stress. I had to have a little break from that stressful exam. And I also went online and got the mark scheme and I've got all the answers here on this iPad. And I've just realized this isn't like ABC like when I did it. They've changed it now, so I'm sure most of you guys know, but you get like numbers. Expectations are very low. I mean, it started off well and then it just went downhill. Question one. Answer was 1019. We've got one right. Yes, right. The first question we got correct. That's one mark. One mark so far. One out of one. 100%. Number two. Positive correlation. Boom. That's two. Two out of two. 100%. Page two. I put 12.45. 12 to one. Yes. That's 3 out of 3. Come on. That was two marks as well. Boom. The weatherman. Yes, that's right. 5 out of 5, absolutely smashing it. This next question, I'm pretty sure this is where it goes downhill. I put 8. The answer was 2 times 2 times 2 times 7. That's wrong. So we're on 5 out of 7 at the moment. Okay, number 4. Show that x squared. Yeah, what is the answer for this? How do I show something? So the question was, show that x squared plus 6x equals 1. I just wrote x equals 1.5 and then wrote the equation. And that's 3 marks. Yes, what are you saying about that? We're back on positive terms. Positive correlation. Okay, what's this? Oh yeah, show the lines are parallel. Start to manipulate expression, e.g. gives equations which can be used to show the gradients of the line are the same. Yep, didn't get that one. Great. Question 7. 72? What do you mean 72? Oh yeah! That's 0 marks again. We've now lost 15 marks and we've still only got 8. Okay, question 8. I put 12. The answer was 0.00000000797. Wrong. Next question. Jules buys a washing machine. Oh, fine. This one's right. Yes, come on, Jules. We've got 10 right and 18 wrong. I don't know what percentage that is because I'm not that good at maths, evidently. Okay, 11. One, two. Yes, we got that one right. A mark. Come on, we're now on 11 marks. Number 12. Oh, I missed this whole bit. Oh no, I thought I missed this out by accident, like I didn't see this page. Then I read it and then realized I had no idea what it was, so I just skipped it. 20, didn't even attempt it. Oh wait, what's this one? 21, I gave a little speech about this one. There isn't actually an answer. I think I guys, come on, let's be honest. I gave a speech about this, and look what it says. 8 angle ABC and BCD, dates link AB and CD. I stated the link verbally. They're almost like butterflies. You know, I stated it. Butterflies. Includes proof by stating triangle, ABC, triangle, DCB with reason, SAS and AC equals BD. Did I not say that? Butterflies. I'm gonna give myself a tick. That's 4 marks for me. A bit arguable, but you know what? I'm taking it. Butterflies. Okay, and the last question we didn't even attempt. I don't think I even looked at it. Oh no, I read it and then I was like, nah, not doing that. There we go. Papers are marks, guys. And now I'm gonna find out what grade I got. I got 16 out of 18. Okay, so to get a 9, you have to get 63, that's an A star, I think. 8, you have to get 52. 7, you have to get 41. 6, you have to get 32. 5, you have to get 23. And 4, you have to get 14, which I got, arguably. So I got a level 4/level 3. Wait, did I get a C? I got a C, yes! 9, 8, and 7 is an A star. 6 and 5 are B's. 4 is a C. I got a C, yes! Arguably a D. Because of the last, you know, was it? I will happily take a C/D. I got a C in the real thing. So to know I can still sustain that level of intellectuality, I will take that with both hands. I am very, very happy with that. The way that went, I didn't think it was gonna be a C. I thought it was gonna be a C, but you know, a sideways C. I don't know about this year's test, but if any of you did the 2018 test, if it was anything like that, I'm genuinely sorry. That was like next level tough. Yeah guys, that's the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, make sure you smash the thumbs up button and comment down below what you thought. Comment down below if you've done your maths GCSE yet. And if you haven't, I mean, I don't think this helped you. But if you haven't done it, make sure you revise, because as you saw today, if you don't revise, you're gonna be lost. I just wanna say to all the people that are currently doing their GCSEs this year, massive good luck. As I said, if any of you did this paper, I'd love to know how yours went. If you did do this paper, comment down below what you got in it and how you found it, because I found it extremely hard. Also, if anyone did did it as a mock exam. Make sure you comment down below and tell me how you did it as well. I want to see how good I am at maths compared to you guys. If you are new, guys, make sure you subscribe for new videos every single week. And make sure you follow me on Instagram and Twitter if you don't already. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. Make sure you comment down below telling me what you thought. I'd love to know what you thought. It was kind of like a different video. Once again, good luck to all of you doing exams, whether they're GCSEs, A-levels, whatever they are. Good luck, and I hope you pass. But yeah, guys, this has been George Mason TV. If you have enjoyed, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. This has been George Mason over and out. Boom. Karen Jackson, ooh, I am for real. Never meant to make your daughter cry. Butterflies.